As you know, there are hundreds of thousands of softwares out there, especially in the e-learning space. It can be really hard to figure out what software you need to use. Well, the cool thing is once you define if you're creating an internal or external e-learning program, your decision of what kind of software to use becomes much easier. Now, in past videos on the channel, we have gone through how you can maximize using Kajabi if you are selling an e-learning program to your learners. So that means you are creating an externally facing e-learning program where you are creating a program that your end goal is to sell it to a business or a consumer. So what we are going to go over today is how to actually build a course or an e-learning program in Kajabi. It's super simple. Now, if you are one of those people who have an internally facing e-learning program where you are looking to train your employees, you can also use Kajabi for that. Just Kajabi is going to give you a lot of tools that you don't necessarily need. But this video specifically, we are going to show you how simple it is to build out an e-learning program in Kajabi. So it may be of value to you as well. Now, welcome to the eLearning Simplified YouTube channel. My name is Johnny Havey. I am one of the co-founders of eLearning Partners, the organization responsible for this YouTube channel. Now, we built this channel to really simplify e-learning for everyone, which is why we recommend this video and specifically this piece of software, Kajabi, to those building an externally facing e-learning program, because it not only hosts courses, it also allows you to sell them. That doesn't mean that if you're building an internally facing e-learning program, you necessarily should stay clear of Kajabi. It just means that you're going to get a lot of other tools that may make the process seem less simple to you. That's why we focus on recommending this to those externally facing programs. Like we said, the goal of this channel is to simplify e-learning for everyone so that you can focus on providing value to your learners as quickly as possible. Kajabi allows you to do that. So let's dive in. If you have been on our channel before, we have a lot of YouTube videos about Kajabi, all in a playlist. And what you're going to want to look at is the Kajabi Basics YouTube video to really get a view of what the back end of Kajabi looks like when you open it up. And again, let's remind you, here is the front end of Kajabi. Here's how much Kajabi is. If you are interested in purchasing Kajabi, we actually have a link for you in the description of this video. And you may be asking, why should I care about using your link? Because you're probably getting paid an affiliate commission for it. Well, yes, we are. But guess what? You use our link and your 14-day free trial of Kajabi will turn into a 28-day free trial. They only allow us affiliates to give that free trial out. The other reason why you would want to use that link is because you like us a lot and you want to show some support to us and our channel. There is no additional cost to you if you go straight to kajabi.com and pay, or if you use our link. Really, all it does is it helps us and it allows us to give you 14 extra days to your free trial when that is active. Now, Kajabi doesn't always have that deal active for us affiliates, but it's active, I would say, 75% of the time. So if you follow that link and you're like, where's my 28-day free trial? These guys lied to me. Not our fault. Kajabi does it seasonally throughout the year. At least you're still showing some support to us. It doesn't cost you anymore. So let's dive in. Let's say you're like, okay, I'm gonna try out the free trial. What you're gonna end up navigating to really see how you actually develop a course in Kajabi is you're gonna click on products here. Then you're gonna click on all products and then create a new product. And here we are creating a new product. Here are the options that we have available today. Now, Kajabi is one of the big players in this space. And the cool thing about Kajabi being one of the big players in this space, and specifically the externally distributing space of e-learning, meaning distributing e-learning programs to an end consumer, your learner wanting to actually purchase from you the product of your course. Well, Kajabi adds more features all the time. You see podcasts right here. This did not exist a year ago. But now you can actually manage the whole build out of your podcast here. Coaching, they built this out recently too. You can manage your entire consulting and coaching practice in Kajabi as well, which is super cool. We're not going over that today. Today we're going over how to build a course. So here's how we create those digital products. You'll see we have options here. We can start with a blank course, start with a mini course, an online course, a drip course. We can also do a membership. So other cool thing about Kajabi is you can actually start a membership site in Kajabi. Yet again, this is not the video for that, but we wanted to point that out. And you can also start a community on Kajabi. Cool thing is you can actually package some of this stuff together. You can build an online course, have your own private community, package those together with some consulting. Pretty cool. Kajabi allows you to do all of that. Kajabi really specializes in being a place that houses digital products, that hosts digital products, and allows you to sell digital products in an automated fashion so that you don't have to take sales calls all day. Instead, Kajabi is doing those sales calls for you. Okay, so how do we create a product? Well, I want to show you what happens when you click on the mini course or the online course. So if I click on the mini course, I say get started, it says mini course description, add a product thumbnail. You're going to want to add all this stuff, very important. This will represent your course on Kajabi. This is what makes up the representation of the product. So we're going to say test. Aren't you so excited? All of us YouTubers just are really creative when we're doing these demos. So test, submit. Now it's gonna take some time, build out the product. Since we picked mini course, it's gonna give us a template that you could technically just fill in a simple mini course. And this is a really good place to start if you're looking at like, I wanna create an online course, not really sure how long it should be. So before you spend a ton of hours, ton of time, ton of money, trying to build out a 100-hour course, the cool thing that you can do is you can build out mini courses, sell them for a much lower price point, and it's gonna take you much less time to create. And what this allows you to do, I don't know if you've taken our masterclass or not yet, but if you have, you would have learned that once you define who your PLP is, who your learner is, you wanna test the market and really see if the course that you're creating answers their biggest challenges. Well, why build out a whole course that's hundreds of hours to do that when you can build out an hour-long course, build it in the Kajabi, and test it that way? A lot less time, a lot less money, and the great thing is you can build upon that course. Just make the mini course into a massive course. But you start small, get that intro price point to a place where your learners can purchase it and give you feedback on the course. So you'll see here how it's broken down, and this is Kajabi's mini course template. What you'll see is there's one category here, and underneath that are 5 pieces of content. So how Kajabi is built out is if I click on add content, it's going to allow me to add a category, a subcategory, a post, or I can upload like a ton of videos all at once. So let's go through what each of these are. A category is what Kajabi uses to organize a bunch of different pieces of content that support one topic. Now, if you've taken our masterclass, if you've watched a lot of videos on our YouTube channel, you'll see that what we would call a category would be a milestone. So we would use the category as our milestone. So if you've built out your MVC, your minimum viable course, we talk about that in our masterclass, we talk about it way more and help you do it in our course, then what you would do is you would take those milestones, let's say your course has 5 milestones, 5 main learning objectives. Yet again, remember, we have a video on our YouTube channel that talks about how milestones is a much better way to look at learning objectives nowadays because it's about the learner. So let's say you have 5 milestones and you have 10 pieces of content that support each of those milestones. Well, what you're going to do is click on that new category, and this is going to be like milestone 1. Add your description, add your thumbnail, create the category. We have milestone 1 here. Then what we can do is add content, and we're going to add a post. And Kajabi calls those individual pieces of content, we would call those modules. Modules are built based on micro-learning. So the best practice of that module or post, as Kajabi calls it, would be to keep that module or post to about 10 minutes. So here's what we would do. We'll say supporting content one. Choose the category, we're gonna put it under milestone one. Boom, so we've created a post, it lives here now. The cool thing also, if you have taken our course, everything we teach in the course maps things out so you can easily take all the content you create and import it into any type of learning management system. Kajabi is just so user-friendly, and if you are creating an externally facing course where you're selling it to your learners, that transition from that CMS we use in our course to Kajabi is seamless. So what you're gonna do now, if we wanna edit what is on our module or post, you're gonna click into the post and you have the title, it's gonna tell you what category it's part of, then we have the media. What you can do is upload a video, upload an audio bite, or you can upload an assessment. And an assessment would just be multiple choice questions or short answer questions that you would want to assess your learners with. You can also add downloads. So you can add like worksheet that is downloadable from this post, etc. And then you can preview it. So this is a blank post, but here's basically what it would look like. The video shows up here. It'll show your instructor here. Comments so people can comment on it. You can add some written content. So go like that, save and refresh. There's the written content. The downloads will show up there as well. So let's see, let's just pick something here. We'll make this as a download. This is a graphic from our course. Just showing you, let's save this, refresh, and here's the download. Just shows up right here, automatically downloads. So pretty cool. So easy for you to create, easy for your learners to digest. So let's go back. You can add subcategories too. You will really only need subcategories if you're building out a massive course. And let's say that your milestones have sub milestones. Let's say you have a milestone that has like three major supporting achievements that your learners need to achieve in order to achieve the milestone. And each of those achievements has like 10 supporting pieces of content. That's where you could go in here and we'll go new subcategory. We'll call this milestone. Let's call this sub milestone one. Choose the top level milestone, create subcategory. Pretty easy. Now the cool thing, like we said, if you chose the mini course as your template, you don't even necessarily need to add everything we just added, and I'll show you how to delete it. So as you can see, these are set as drafts, which means that they are not live. If you send them to publish, they'll be live. If you send them to drip, they will become live when you choose for them to become live. That could be an automated piece. You can lock them so that they have to be unlocked. So the difference between dripping and locking is when you drip, you're gonna be releasing course content slowly over time. When you lock, what that means is you can only access specific course content when you complete other course content. And then you can just have everything live at all times. So here we go, we're back to the mini course. So if you want to just create a mini course, literally, you can change these titles to like the name of your course. So test course, test mini course one, save category. And then you have your welcome, lesson one, lesson two, lesson three, and your conclusion. Pretty simple, you can click into these. They have some copy in here already. You can add your videos, etc. Now you probably want a mini course that's longer than five lessons, but you get the point. Now, the cool thing is, if you don't want, for example, the breadcrumb to be category, you can actually change what that looks like in the back end and make that actually be milestones. And it'll say test course, milestones, milestone one, supporting content one. So you can make those changes. We have advanced videos about Kajabi on our channel and in our course that you can check out. But let's go to customize here. You can customize how you want your course to look by creating that customize. So let's see what happens when we click on online course now. So I click on online course, test course two, submit. Here we go. So now what we do is Kajabi is going to add the finishing touches to the course. It's going to be much longer. It's going to be a much longer template for you to fill out. So it's taking longer. You can grab a cup of coffee and check an email. You can work on your PLPs. Look at this. We got a bunch of categories now. We have 5 categories. Under the categories, we have posts, concept one, concept two, the what, the why, the how. So this is cool. So if you want a template for your course, Kajabi has it. If you want to start a blank course, here's what you're going to do. Click on the blank and test course three. Submit. It's going to build my product. Hopefully it doesn't take as long. Adding finishing touches. Or is it right here? I think it's right here. Poke. So here's what a blank course looks like. It has a blank category, a blank post. You already know how to add content. You can actually upload multiple pieces of video content as well. So if you have like 10 videos and you want to create an individual post one at a time, you can upload them here. So that's how you do this on the product side. In the next video in this series, we are going to go through how to take your product that you created in Kajabi, build an offer around it. And then even further into this series of Kajabi videos, we're gonna show you how you take that offer and you build an automated sales funnel for your digital products. And lastly, if you don't have a website or if you wanna create your own website to specifically sell your digital products, we will show you how to use Kajabi to do that as well. Now, if you're not sure if you have an internally facing or externally facing e-learning program, or you just want to clarify who your learners are even more so you can build the perfect mini course in Kajabi, or maybe you're ready to build out that full 10-20 hour course in Kajabi, take our masterclass. It is a free masterclass. You'll get instant access. It's linked in the description below. It's amazing. It's all about how to guarantee the success of your e-learning program, online course, or virtual training every single time you decide to build one. Now, if you like this video and you're really pumped for the rest of this content, all about how you can use Kajabi to maximize the value of your externally facing e-learning program, which means you're selling to your customers, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. We have more and more content coming out all about Kajabi. We'll see you in the next video.